Welcome to the part 2 of IoT based transmission line monitoring system using Raspberry Pi. So now, as we in the previous video, we can see we have checked the status and how to clear and how to download the ThingSpeak app. And coming to the kit explanation, so whenever the fault is identified, means we are going to changing the voltage and current from this input potentiometers, and it will be identified the LM358 comparator. There will be two another potentiometers, so these are set the input reference voltage to the comparator. So whenever the abnormalities occurred, so now let us see the output. So now I'm increasing that. There will be the two indications. One is on the LCD and another is with the LED indication. And whenever these normal conditions occurred, then automatically the relay gets switched on and the status will be normal on LCD. As you can see that the current fault is raised to the 1 and the relay is got down to the 0 as is off. And now we are going to setting this as a normal. When it is current is normal, then the relay gets switched on and the status is normal on LCD. So as the previous data is showing, and now after 10 seconds, between the 10 seconds duration only, so now it is coming to the normal position. And coming to the voltage, I'm increasing the voltage fault occurred, and the same status will be displayed on the ThingSpeak. So the main purpose of the ThingSpeak is we can see the status of the voltage fault and current fault and the relay status from anywhere in the world, and also we can get this historical data, so we can maintain the data log. And it can be downloaded as I showed in the previous video with Excel sheet format. That is a CSV format, comma separated values format. Okay. And coming to this circuit, so as the transmission lines are going to be the AC, so for that we are going to convert the AC to DC using this bridge rectifier 4 diodes. And after that we are using a 7805 regulator, and the voltage will be given to the comparator. So this comparator will check the input voltage from this reference potentiometers as the input potentiometers by comparing these two and current these two. So based on the reference voltage from these two, and the comparator will make the decision and inform to the Raspberry Pi. In the Raspberry Pi we wrote the Python language code. So based on the input signals from the respective pins, we are going to display the status on the LCD, and the same status will be uploaded to the ThingSpeak using internet, which we enable the hotspot and a phone. So this continuously going on, so its historical data can be stored in a longer duration also. So for better appearance, just clear that as I shown in the previous video. And before clearing the channel, we need to download the data and thereafter clear the channel. And coming to this Raspberry Pi 0W, we are using as it's an inbuilt Wi-Fi. So from that we are going to sending the data to the ThingSpeak. Thank you for watching demo.